I think one of the initial challenge with the startup space is on cash management. And since I am a taxation person, I think one value I can contribute is to say that, you know, this cash management can very well be done by very simple knowledge of some tax planning, tax savings opportunity. And one of them is, you know, doing a withholding tax planning. So when a, you know, startup receives money from its client, it is subject to tax withholding. And this could be at a very high rate of, let's say, 10%. But if you have losses and you are not into profits, then there is a window or a prescribed mechanism under the tax regime where you can actually approach the tax authorities, get a lower withholding tax certificate so that, you know, your taxes are deducted at a lower rate or a nominal rate, and then you do cash management. So effective way of doing cash management. With our demographics, I think one sector clearly would be EdTech, with the kind of, you know, domestic demographics we have. That itself offers a great opportunity for EdTech companies to, you know, do great and scale immensely. So that's one sector I would be personally investing and putting my bets in. I think at some point of time, the realization has to come that, you know, we have whatever we are doing, we have to pass it on and, you know, give this as a legacy to the next generation. And that's where I think the realization would be that more than money, it is the purpose and values which will be more important. And surely the entrepreneurs, you know, should keep a watch for so as to provide a good legacy to our next generation. Yeah, this has been my first visit and absolutely amazed to see the campus and the efforts which are putting in. So happy, you know, one of the big things which this country was lacking was a good education infrastructure. And I'm so happy to see, you know, universities like SNU stepping up and doing that bit. So very happy and very proud to be associated with SNU University. Thank you.